everybody, this is Michael once again, and welcome to another edition of A Month of Horror. That's right, celebrating horror films all the month of October, which unfortunately only has one day left. We wish that this month could go on forever. But guys, today on the top 10, I'm counting down my... Did I hear somebody say my... Yes, I said my list of the sexiest women in horror film. Now, some of these films are decades old and all that, but I'm speaking of the person in the film at the time as far as being very, very sexy. And once again, guys, let me reiterate, this is my list, my personal choices here, my favorite. So if someone you like is not on the list, this is my preference. You understand that, right? Okay. But anyway, guys, I wrote my list down here. I've got me something cool to drink because undoubtedly it's going to get hot in here. I mean, let's face it, guys, women in film, a definitely hot commodity. I mean, women are gorgeous. We love women. We love hot women. We love sexy women. But anyway, guys, counting down the top 10. Number 10 is a woman that I saw for the first time in the film From Beyond. And in that film, she actually took off her clothes and put on this sadomasochist outfit and climbed atop a very lucky character in the film and rode him. Well, she didn't actually ride him, but she was on top of him. And then I saw her in the movie The Reanimator, where she was completely nude in Bush and all, and not Barbara Bush. And then, of course, I saw her next in the movie Chopping Mall, where she did this topless scene. And of course, I'm speaking of the lovely Barbara Crampton, who is a very sexy woman. Definitely a very sexy woman. And probably The Reanimator is probably the most sexy I've ever seen her. So that's my number 10 spot, Barbara Crampton. What? I didn't say yours? Oh, I'm sorry. Let me reiterate again. This is my list. I'm sorry. I didn't mean to mislead you guys. Next on the list at number 9, we have a character that I saw in one film. Now, she didn't get naked or take off her clothes or anything like that, guys. And that's the beauty of this list. You know, a woman does not have to be naked to be sexy. Sometimes sexuality is just a possession that certain people have. You know, what can I say? But... Yes, you're sexy too, okay? For a skeleton. But anyway, guys, next at number 9, guys, we have the girl from the film Hellraiser. Yes, the damsel in distress, and that is Ashley Lawrence. And like I said, she didn't undress or anything like that, but there was just something very, very sexy about her to me. I thought she was a very beautiful and sexy young woman. Okay, guys, at the number 8 spot, another female heroine who I believe came into her beauty in the film Wes Craven's New Nightmare. And of course, I'm speaking of Heather Langenkamp. Now, when I first saw the original Nightmare on Elm Street, I always thought that Heather Langenkamp was a very pretty and attractive woman. But when I seen her in Wes Craven's New Nightmare, she was grown up and she was just gorgeous, just really gorgeous and lovely, a really kind of sophisticated, sexy kind of look about her, and that's when I fell in love with her all over again. And that's Heather Langenkamp. Excuse me, guys. These candles are hot. Okay. Number 7 on the list. Oh, wow. This is a chick that I saw for the first time in the movie Phantoms with Ben Affleck. Affleck! No, not that Affleck, but Ben Affleck. And I couldn't keep my eyes off of her. I mean, she didn't undress, she wasn't nude, anything like that. It's just that it was just one of those attractions where I just thought, God, there's just something about this woman. And, you know, she's appeared in other films where she's, you know, not so well-dressed. She's been in model shoots where she's done really sexy outfits, but I've never seen her appear as sexy and fully clothed as she was in that film. And I'm speaking of Rose McGowan. And God, she was just really, really beautiful to me in Phantoms. I just could not stop watching her. What was that movie about anyway? You remember? You were in it. Yeah. He's psychic. Okay, guys. Rose McGowan at number 7. At number 6, this is a woman who, to me, derides her sexuality from her inner strength. A strong woman can be sexy. And the female that I'm speaking of came from the film The Ring. And I'm speaking of Naomi Watts. Just a really sexy kind of take charge attitude. A woman that's not only strong, but she's vulnerable. She's protective. And I found those traits about her very, very sexy. Now, it's not that she's the most beautiful woman in the world, but she's definitely sexy. Her traits are sexy. So that's number 6 on the list, Naomi Watts. Okay, guys. At number 5, a female that I first saw in the film Final Destination. She was one of a number of teens that I felt she really stuck out when I saw this movie in the theater. Just thought she was really gorgeous. Just inundated with sexuality. And of course, I'm speaking of Ali Larter, who went on to play other films, the Resident Evil films, among just a few. But a very, very sexy actress. Just gorgeous. And she just exudes with sexuality. Just Ali Larter, guys. Okay. If I can only get this cold drink to go all the way down, if you men know what I mean. Cool off everything. Okay, guys. Number 4 on the list is a female that I first saw in the sequel to, and I can't remember the name of the film. It's the film with Bo Derek and Christopher Atkins when they were stranded on that island and they came into puberty and started having sex and everything. I can't remember the name of the film, but this lady appeared in the sequel. Yes, there was a sequel. And she was a very cute actress, but later on I seen her in more adult roles, and she kind of had a problem keeping her clothes on in her roles. But then, when it came to the Resident Evil films, the star, Mila Jovovich, I thought was just a very, very take charge, a very strong, a fighter, definitely a fighter. I found those qualities about her to be very, very sexy. And at my number 4 spot, guys, is Mila Jovovich. Just I still think she's a very sexy actress. And all the Resident Evil films that I've seen her in, just, God, she's just overflowing with sexuality. Just a very, very sexy woman. It's those eyes. I can look into those eyes, and I just melt. I rush right to the bathroom. No, I'm kidding. But she does have very, very sexy eyes, guys. Just a gorgeous. It's kind of like similar. Not saying like gorgeous. Oh, she's gorgeous. It's kind of like when you say God. You know, you don't say, oh, God. You say God. So, you know, Mila Jovovich is gorgeous. Okay. Gotta cool off. Okay, guys. At number 3, we have a lady that, you know, not a lot of people think is sexy. You don't think of the word sexy when it comes to this lady, because mainly because she plays such tough roles where she's always just so tough and butch, and she's always a tough character in every film that she does. And I think that a lot of times that kind of excludes her to the audience of the fact that she's really quite a stunningly beautiful girl. She has a lot of sexual qualities about her. She's very, very sexy. And I'm speaking of Michelle Rodriguez. And she's kind of an underrated female when it comes to movies, because she's quite the looker. She has quite the body. And I know, and usually you're seeing it in all these military outfits and she's all covered up. She doesn't really appear very sexy in her films, but she is a very stunning woman, and it's just all that attitude that she has that makes her so sexy. Okay. So we have Michelle Rodriguez at number three. At number two, and I can't think of one role this woman's ever done other than the film that I'm thinking of now. And she appeared in The Avengers. And I think she first appeared, at least when I first saw her, she was in one of the Iron Man films. But I'm speaking of Scarlett Johansson. When she's appearing in that role in The Avengers and the superhero films, oh, she's just gorgeous. When I first saw The Avengers, I was so captivated by her beauty. It was just magnetic. I'm looking at this woman and I'm thinking, wow, she is fucking wearing the hell out of that costume. I mean, I could have married the costume. I could have had sex with the costume. Yeah. Yeah. Don't even wash it. Just, you know, just sweat all in it and I'll take it. But anyway, Scarlett Johansson, she has never appeared any more sexy than she has in the Marvel superhero films. She is number two on my list. Okay, guys. Last but not least, you know, you're sitting there wondering, who's it gonna be? Who's it gonna be? Let me say, guys, before I announce the number one sexiest woman in film on my list, I gotta say that once again, this is my list. I don't want to see any comments saying why didn't you put this woman on there. Personal preference, you know, I don't understand why that's so hard to understand, but feel free, guys, you know, for those of you who can't, that I didn't put a woman on the list that you love, feel free to make a video response and list her there. But anyway, just thought I'd add that. It was his suggestion. But anyway, finally, at number one, guys, we have an actress that's been around for quite some time. I've always thought that this actress was very, very sexy, very, very captivating, just stunningly beautiful. The last film that I saw her in was Prometheus. And, of course, the first scene in the film that she's in, she's on the floor in these little bitty shorts with her ass cheeks hanging out. Of course, I'm speaking of Charlize Theron. I just think that, you know, generally, every role that I've seen this woman in, she's just gorgeous. She just radiates with heat. She is hot. She leaves me speechless. So there you have it, guys. Charlize Theron, the number one sexiest horror film woman on my list. Feel free to make your own list, guys. I would be more than happy to share the heat with you guys. Women. Ah, you just love women. Women. There's just so many varieties. They come in all shapes and sizes. And we love hot women. That's my top 10 sexiest horror film vixens. Feel free to create your own. Thanks for watching, everybody. Take care. And I'll see you at the next A Month of Horror video.